Alright, barabara, asante sana. Dugu brother wapenzi watazamaji, na sasa this time round ni moja kwa moja hadi kwenye ruti za mwanzo mwanzo wa sinema. Na hili picha is a special dedication kwa watoto wote. Kama we ni mtoto, hii movie is a special dedication kwako. Na kama we sio mtoto, saa hii nataka ujifanye mtoto ili tukae kama watoto, ili tuweze kuona utoto wa watoto. It's a special dedication to all the kids. Yesu akasema, wachani watoto wote wakuje kwangu, na kubalikiwa ni atakaye jifanya kama mtoto. Kwa hivyo sasa, dugu brother mpenzi mtazamaji,
but what I'm going to wish, I'm going to wish for all these funds in the marriage. Just big opportunity.
Oh, yes, yes. Quick, open the trap. I'll tell you what's happening.
One, a little dignity, your grace.
I'm giving you this gracious Nutella of a school. We have to leave at once. Firing has broken out in the city.
Oh, dear. Do you think they have to ask? Why should they? Why? Then put him down a moment. Grab my bag and get my crippled soccer colored shoe. I'll leave them for the green dress.
Go calmly into battle.
Madam, please, we must leave at once.
Why? I have to take my silver dress. It cost me $1,000.
Tell me I have to put out of the city, please.
The white colored dress.
Where's the job? Where's the job?
Mario, get the baby ready. Oh!
In olden times, in a bloody time, yeah, yeah, oh. In olden times, in a bloody time, they ruled in a Caucasian city. Men called it the city of the damned. A governor, his name George Abashvili. He was rich as crocious. He had a beautiful wife. He had a healthy baby. No other governor in Brusinia had so many horses at his table, so many petitioners at his courtyard, and so many beggars at his doorstep. George Abashvili. How shall I describe him to you? On the morning of Easter Sunday, the governor and his family went to church.
Whatever I do, my friends, I do well. This morning at the church's door, I said to George Abashvili, I love a gay sky. Actually, I prefer the lightning that comes out of a gay sky. Yes, indeed. It's a pity though. They took the brat along, but I need him urgently. Let's go. What are you going to do?
Nothing. If boss comes to us, I have a brother in commodity. How about you?
Well, forget about me. But your wish to know my plans fills me with satisfaction.
I've been ordered to accompany Madame Mashili as a guard.
But hasn't the palace guard me sent?
That's a fact.
Isn't it dangerous to go with her?
Well, in Tiflis they say, isn't the stabbing dangerous for the knife?
You are not a knife. You are a man. And what does that woman have to do with you
that
anyway?
That woman has nothing to do with me. I have my orders and I go.
The soldier is big-headed. He's running into danger for nothing. Nothing at all. I must get into that courtyard. I'm in a hurry.
Well, since we're both in a hurry, I am asking very sincerely for your hand.
Why are you And why did you ever leave? This land is our life. Your world is the open sea.
We are simple working men. We don't have much to say.
Why did you leave Caucasian and leave us here to stay?
That is where we stopped three Nazi tanks. Yes. But the apple orchard was already destroyed.
Our beautiful dairy farms are ruined.
Yes!
I started the fire myself, comrades.
Oh, so
comrades.
Listen to the report. The collective got from Rosa Luxemburg, formerly located right here in this valley, moved east on orders from the government. Now the plan is to return.
No.
But the collective fruit farm, Galinsky,
their neighbors, propose that this land be assigned unto them.
Yes.
They would like to plant vineyards and orchards there,
representing
the Reconstruction Commission. I would like to request that these two collective farms sit down and decide whether Rosa Luxemburg is to return here or not.
Well, first of all, I'd like to protest against this time limit.
Now you see, we of the Rosa Luxemburg have traveled for 3 days and three nights. And now you want to tell us that discussion has been limited to half a day?
We haven't as much villages as we used to have. We haven't as much time as we used to have.
Yes!
And also, we haven't as much hands as we used to have.
All pleasures have to be rationed. Tobacco is rationed and wine. Discussion should be rationed.
There to the fascist. Well, let me just go straight and explain why we want our valley back.
Makina Bakize, please unpack the goat cheese.
Coaches. Eat, comrades. Enjoy.
Is this a way of influencing us?
Yeah, that's nice.
How can it be a way of influencing you, Surab? Valley thief. Now, everybody knows you'll take the valley and the cheese too. What we want from you is a very honest answer. Do you love the cheese?
Yes, I like it.
Yes, I like it. Of course, I knew you'll know nothing about cheese.
Why? When I told you I like it?
Because you cannot like it. It is not as good as it used to be. And why? Because our grazing land is not as good as it used to be.
And why? Because the grazing fields are not as good as they used to be, so the young folks say. It doesn't even smell like morning in the morning, right?
Yeah.
Now put that into the report.
Don't mind them.
They have got your point. After all, why does a man love his own country?
Why?
Because the bread tastes better there.
Better.
The air smells better.
Mm-hmm.
Voices are strong.
Stronger. Yes.
The sky is high and the earth. It's easy to work on. Isn't that so?
Yes. The land belongs to us through all eternity.
Yes. Look
at this person.
What do you mean by all eternity? Nothing belongs to anyone by all eternity. Even when you're born, you never belong to yourself. You belong to Kazbeki, the princess.
Yes.
Okay. Well, the land belongs to us by law.
What are you?
In any case, the laws must be re-examined to see if they are still right.
This goes without saying. But let me ask you.
Does it matter the kind of tree that stands next to your house? Does it? Or maybe the kind of neighbors you have? Does it? You see?
We only wanted to come back and have you as our neighbors.
Yes.
Wonderful, 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 wonderful. Valley thieves. Now you can laugh again. Why don't you hear what our agricultural specialist, Kato Vashtang, has to say about the valley?
Exactly. We are not drawing what you had to say about this farm, eh? The houses were not fully destroyed. As for the dairy farms, the foundation is still there.
If your new grazing field is as bad as you say, then you have a good reason to claim state support.
Comrade specialist, We are not horse trading.
Yes.
I can't take your cup, give you another and say, yours is better.
Yes.
But it might be better, but you still prefer your own.
Definitely.
A piece of land is not a cap. Not in our country, comrade.
Don't be angry.
Yes, it is true. But a piece of land is just but a tool to produce something useful.
But there's also such a thing like love for a particular land. In any event, what we need to know is what exactly you people are going to do with the valley once you have it.
Yes. Okay, let Kato speak.
Yes.
Comrades, last winter when we were fighting in these hills as partisans, we discussed how, once the Germans were expelled, we could build up our fruit culture to 10 times its original size. I have prepared a plan for the irrigation project. With a dam across our mountain lake, we could water to 700 acres of infertile land. Our farm could not only grow more fruits, but support vineyards too. This project, however, would only pay if the disputed value of the Rosa Luxemburg farm were also included. And here are the calculations.
Put it into the report that it is also our collective farm to start a new stud farm.
Yes, comrades. The project was conceived during days and nights when we had to run for a cover to the mountains. Often, we hadn't even enough ammunition for a half dozen rifles. We could hardly lay our hands on a pencil.
Oh, many thanks to the Galinsk, our neighbors, and to all those who fought for our country. Many thanks.
He's in rags.
That's not true. I wasn't given enough time to put on his best shirt.
He must have been from a pigsty.
I am not a pig. But there are those who are.
Where did you leave the child?
I will kill you for it. This is a criminal.
Order. No. Plaintiff versus defendant. You see, the court has not really come to a conclusion on who the real mother of the child is. Now, I, as the judge, I am obligated to choose the right mother for the child. Now, shall we?
Yes, Your Honor.
Draw a circle at the center of this court.
Yes, Your Honor.
Shall we?
Yes, Your Honor.
Put the child at the center of that circle.
Yes, Your Honor.
Wonderful, wonderful. Now, both mothers stand next to the child. The rest of you sit down. Now listen to the instructions carefully. The woman who will pull this child from the center of this circle is the real mother of the child. Now in the count of three, you pull. Three? No. Hold the child by the hand. Good. Now three.
I object. High Court of Justice.
The fate of the great Habashwili estates, which are tied to the child as the heir, should not be made dependent by this doubtful doing. In addition, my client here does not command the strength of that woman who is accustomed to physical work.
But your client here looks well fed to me. I will continue with the test. Now hold the child by the arm. In the count of three, you pull. Now three. Two. One. And pull.
Congratulations.
Why didn't you pull?
I did not hold on to him, Your Honor.
Why?
Your Honor, I take back everything I said against you. But can I at least keep him until he can speak all the words? He only knows a few.
He only knows a few. Don't try to influence the court. I bet you only know 20 words yourself. All right. I'll repeat the test just to be sure. Shut up. Now who are the child?
Yes, Your Honor.
Very soon.
That one. What mothers hold the child by the hand? In the count of three, each one of you now pulls. A three, a two, a one, and pull. Wonderful.
Come, I baby, raised come. Him. Shall I also tear him into pieces?
Come, baby, come. Come, baby, come. Come, baby, come, baby. Wonderful. Now, in this man, the court has finally determined who the real mother of this child is. Natala Bashili. Take your child.
Your Honor,
you get out of here before I judge you for fraud.
But Your Honor.
And by the way, your estates have been converted to become playground. Yes, playground for these children. You know, they need it.
After that evening, Azdak vanished and was never seen again. The people of Krusinia did not forget him, but long remembered his moment of judgment as a brief golden age, almost an age of justice. Now, for those of you who have watched the story of the Caucasian chalk sucker, take heed what men of old said. That which is good will go to those who are good for it.